So you and Greta met at the Toronto Film Festival
yeah.
in 2015
yeah.
and did a read-through. What happened?
Well, we had Skyped beforehand, maybe a couple of weeks beforehand, and it was the giddiest Skype meeting I've ever had. We hadn't met before, and we just got on, and we were like, I love you, and I love you, and you're so great. And we didn't even really talk about the script that much, I don't think. sorry, what do you want me to do? And so anyway, then a couple of weeks later, we were both at the festival. She was there for something, and she was doing 20th Century Women at the time, so she had like flaming red hair and just looked so cool, and basically looked like an older version of Lady Bird. And we sat down and we read the script, and as far as I was concerned, it was an audition. It was an audition. And I sort of, I understood her, but I didn't know what to do with her, which I think is how a lot of maybe characters feel in the film. They're sort of like, who is this person? What is she? And I really understood, you know, the difficulty she had, but I really didn't, I was like, how do I play someone like this, you know? Because she's funny, but she's also, she doesn't mean to be necessarily, and she's so sincere and sort of like serious. and so that's just what I did, and but I didn't know if she liked it or not. And then I heard a few days later that she wanted me to do it.
She had to wait for you.
Yeah, a year. Yeah.
Because of the Crucible.
Because of the Crucible, yeah. So we would meet up, because I was doing it in New York and Greta lives there, we would meet up, and Beanie and Lucas and Laurie, we would come to her apartment and we'd look through her, you know, photo albums from when she was a kid. She was there. We didn't break in. yeah, and so we just sort of like studied that world at that time. And it was great, and so we sort of got to know each other a bit. Greta and I had spent quite a bit of time together, and then we just went straight into it in September.
So what was it like being directed by a woman, and was it different? I've seen you two together. You two are great together, but...
Well, the thing is, for me, like, the very first director I worked with was a woman, was Amy Heckerling, and I have worked with more men than women, but I've worked with quite a few brilliant directors who happen to be women. So I've never really separated the two, and I didn't in this case either. She's just a great filmmaker. I think, you know, with this story, the fact that it's obviously focusing on a young teenage girl, there was a sensibility there and a sensitivity that only someone who's experienced that would have. But, you know, when it comes to her skill and her craft and her experience, she's just, you know, she's brilliant and she's smart and she reads people very well and she's very open and she's learned an awful lot from the other great directors that she's worked with in the past, so...
Yeah, no. I wondered if she wasn't almost inspirational for you.
Yeah, she was when we were making the film, and even before I met her, I loved her, and I loved the kind of work that she did, and even just her style of acting. I feel like she's like developed her own style, and I knew that she was smart and really was going to do her own thing. But I have to say, more than any other sort of stage of our relationship, watching her release this film into the world and share it with you all and talk about it and to see how passionate she is about her baby and her actors and cinema has been completely inspiring to me. It really has. And to just see, and in this case, seeing a woman do it, I suppose it allows us to put ourselves in their shoes and go, oh, maybe I can do that too. So it's been really brilliant to watch her just soar, you know.